Hey there, welcome to JsonWorld. Today we will discuss about the communication of data between multiple components with the help of different ways. So this is my first video on data sharing between multiple components in Angular application. So while Angular app development, we come across multiple scenarios where we need to share data between multiple components. So this time I am sharing this video on this topic. So the first one I'm going to explain you is via the input decorator. Here you can see there are various ways by which data can be shared between multiple components. So let's start from the base. So here you can see I've created a very basic application in which I have added a child component and started the server. So once I start the server, normally you get this kind of interface with basic ng new command. Mm-hmm. Now let's proceed with the code level stubs. Here you can see we have very basic stubs here. So now we will change the content as per our requirement. So I am now modifying the content of TS file. We will not use HTML file since everything will be in TS file to make things clear. Now I am modifying the parent component. Here app component is working as a parent component and child app is working as a child component. So let's work on this file first. So here you can see we have made the changes as per our requirement. So here I have simply created two variables. First one will show here only from the parent component, and the second one we will pass from parent component to child component. So here, after removing this HTML file URL, I am just putting here the HTML code. Now our child component is changed as per the requirement. So you can see I have created a underscore get message of string type, and on this variable we have made the changes with the help of input decorator. So setter and getter method I have used here to set the value or modify the value or to return the value. So once value comes to this component, these two methods updates the value and returns the updated value to the page. So now if we run the application, then we can see two values here. This one is printing from parent component and this one is printing from child component after this particular text has been added from the child component. If we add something at this place, test parent, and here I am using edit to cross verify the things are working as expected or not. Now our build has I think run, so you can see it's test parent error. So this way we can perform the task. In the next video, I will share you the data communication from child component to parent component with the help of output decorator. Thanks a lot for watching this video.